Progress redeemed ministries, redeemed by the grace. By the grace we can do all things and move from grace to grace. So now get ready.
Why that mountain has stayed too long? And what is required of you to overcome it? I'm going to repeat it three times. It is a question to you. Sometimes these questions are around us, but we are not even ready to ask our very own
selves.
Why has it taken too long? And what is required of you? Praise the Lord. Now, ladies and gentlemen, time is come and go, and so seasons. But each of them will come with a purpose and with an aim in our life. But what I know, certain things, if written not too good, it is always good that they take a shorter time in our lives and then they can go away. Praise the Lord. But if they take too long, they come with other consequences. Amen. I'll give an example of barrenness, for example. If you can sustain it for 3 years, I can say maybe it will be a bit bearable. But if it stretches to 20 years, it comes with a lot of consequences. So my take this afternoon is, the shorter the time that circumstance depends, the better for you and me. Hallelujah. I am underscoring the fact that yes, as some of these challenges they have come. Because at times they are intended to organize us. Prepare us for the next level.
But
my prayer is that you shall not allow such circumstances to stay too long. How many people agree with me? I am saying that the shorter the time, whichever the challenge you are going through today, the better for you and me. I want to imagine a situation where even up to today, and this church is a papyrus church. Up to now, I tell you, we will be in trouble. I do not know how we are going to explain the people of this generation. By that time, it was okay. That was the situation everywhere. Everybody was coming from the house like that. So people were waiting. Now you are saying you are going to keep in the same situation. 5 years! 20 years! Somebody tap your neighbor and say that if it has taken too long, let it go today in the name of Jesus. So they might say that if it has taken too long, suffer. Do not entertain the people who keep on telling you such things. Praise the Lord. Assuming it's a famine. Hallelujah. No, about if it was a famine. A famine, a njala. Or a drought. And the country allows that drought to take so long. The same drought you have been having, has taken quite a short time, in my view. Nevertheless, there are serious effects. People have started crying everywhere. Now, this is what I'm talking about. That spirit comes. Oh no. If it comes, it has come. Can we concentrate on finding a way to have it sorted out in the shortest time possible? There are many people who are here and they believe that actually suffering is supposed to be part of their life. I just say you to be far back to God's word. No, suffering is not part of you. It's not supposed to be part of your life. Yes, sometimes it's a process. Now, in my view, there is one powerful point I have so far made. And the question which ran through my heart was that there could be people who are here. And for sure, as she's announcing, you'll be asking vividly, see a reason why you shall come and be part of that service. And I'm saying that by the grace of God, by the grace of God, come next Sunday, you shall have a bigger reason. A sound reason to be part of that service in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Job chapter number 42. I'm going to read a few verses. And I will only read a verse where I find it very necessary. But I can summarize for you. And I said that Job and his suffering and the challenges he had, they took him near 39 years. I request that you shall repeat it now. It took near 39 years in that suffering. Everybody of you, I'm sure you have heard about Job. You know what happened to Job. But I'm saying whatever happened to him, tough and difficult as it was, it took him 9 years. Turn to your neighbor and say, what a very long period of time. Come on, say to them and say it was too long. Come on, say it was too long. Come on, say it was too long. And I try to imagine what it means. Someone to be in extreme poverty for 5 years. Have you ever thought about it? 5 years. What a long period. And listen, hallelujah. I want to see someone raising up their hand and saying, I believe in the situation that take a short time. Hallelujah. When you agree with me, I'm going to end the congregation. Because if it takes too long, it can be so bad. Hallelujah. Why does it take too long at times? Why should I say that you want to go in here? I request that you pen it down. Write the word sin. Sin, S-I-N. Why at times it takes too long? Now, sin brings calamity. It brings poverty. It produces diseases. And the worst of all, it can cause death. Where we have written sin as the reason why mountains take too long in people's lives. Continue and say that this is medicine produces the four things. Poverty is bad. Calamity is bad. Disease. And death.
Hallelujah.
I want to whisper a song that says, I'm going to get tired of sin. Come and say, I'm going to get tired of sin. Come and say, I'm going to get tired. From this very moment. Now the Bible teaches that in the whole of the East, nobody was greater than
you.
In wealth, in riches, wisdom, in the whole of the East. Job was not a rich man of Uganda. No, he carried a bigger area. A whole continent. When you talk about the East, because you now talk about China,
talk
about Israel, mention all those countries. Job was greater than all of them. He was a great man. By the natural world standards, I want you to agree with me that Job was a great man. Nobody was found greater than him in the whole
of it.
Was a powerful man.
Hallelujah.
Why?
The
Bible says he had been a righteous man. Moving with God. Now what happened? His man was righteous. What went wrong? Okay, if it happened, why to take a 9 years?
The answer
I have given you
is
the sin.
It's
me. Now let me tell you something. You are going to say, but Job was a righteous man. The Bible says it's so. No, when did Job go wrong? When these circumstances came, God is trouble again. This is what happened.
Which
part of your hand? Number 1.
It's okay that
Job started to complain. In the beginning chapters, he tried to avoid. But I tell you what, sometime later,
he
complained. Well, number 2, Job believed that he was a righteous man. And so it was unjust for God to allow such things to happen in Israel. But
the
Bible teaches that the wisdom and the understanding of God is the supreme and cannot be questioned. Everything that suffers for 7 9 years, including the wife and nation of God. Hallelujah. As they were there, the situation kept on growing. More things kept on dying. More challenges kept on piling up.
Hallelujah.
I tell you what.
What I hated first in my life. It is sin.
I remember
with the Lord when I was still young.
I tell you by God's grace. I have led a neat life. Nothing I have that I got in a crooked way. I have by God's grace moved from my
day,
fulfilling every step of life as
it
is supposed to do and be. I also do not mind, and also do not care, even when things become tough. I always know that someday, somewhere, the Lord who is so faithful, He will come to my rescue. For those of you over there, and you have never dreamt of fighting wars, I challenge you to join me and to fight battles I have led a life of fighting wars. And I'm happy to be a warrior. By God's grace. Why? Every war I have participated in, I have always come out with a victory. So when you come to my house, I will tell you that came out of battle number so. This and this came out of the other war. That and that. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, all of you, including me, the Lord has called us to the ministry of fighting wars.
And
I
must
say that our God is a fighter. He keeps on fighting battles and wars. Now let me remind you something. The Bible says that immediately they reached the land of Canaan. God said it was true. The men were giants. Land was powerful. The cities were fortified cities. Hallelujah. And now these cowards, they started complaining. Bible says, over 10 elders. 10 elders. They were not elders in the church here. They were also elders by leading a whole tribe in Israel. And I want to say to you, that was a powerful commitment. And the man who was able to lead the whole tribe of Israel, he must have been a powerful man. He must have been a fighter. He must have been a giant in faith and in the spirit. Nevertheless, Bible says, they fear greatly. And they cried tears. They said, it's impossible. Now let me draw your attention back to this man, Moses. Moses says like this, go and see how the whole thing looks like. For the people are weak, for they are strong, for the cities are big, for they are smaller. Now, God
Katonda
and his mission did not care how the place looked like. The point was for them to see and come back on a preparing table and work out a war plan. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. I want us to put the solutions. If sin can hold us too long, what do we do? Somebody's
going
to say, I never have led a perfect life. And everybody knows it. No. Let me tell you, the greatest prayer, the most impacting prayer that you will ever make, and it touches God's heart, is a prayer of acknowledging that you are not worth and you do not deserve. Any man who goes before God and they are sincere in their heart and they make that prayer, you will surely come out with victory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is coming to
the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Chapter Asat
Mumwenda. 39. Yo is there.
What are we going to do? Get a pen and write and say, deep repentance. Thanks so much. I've put the word deep. She has interpreted it so well. You need to repent. But your repentance, this time around, let it go deeper. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Before somebody is saying, but he has not read the verses at all. No, we are going to read these verses. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse number 5 and 6. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to read verse 5 and 6. The book of Job, chapter number 42. It says, I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear, but now my eye sees you.
Nari ulideko no kulira okutu. Naye kakana eriiso yange likulaba.
This is Job. Tell your neighbor, this is Job now. Verse number 6. Now listen to verse number 6.
Therefore I humble myself and repent in the dust and ashes.
Nari ulideko no kulira okutu. Naye kakana eriiso yange likulaba.
Somewhere in his report.
Praise the Lord. Tell your neighbor that everything that you repent, tell your neighbor. Everything that you repent,
that made me succeed like the many times I have repented.
Many
times I'm in the car traveling, but I'm repenting about the whole of this country. I am praying God for this nation. One day I went to the saloon. And so I discovered what those people were doing was very ungodly. Now when they finished, they went. But that thing disturbed me for a whole month. I didn't know their names. But I kept on crying to God. I kept on repenting because of what I saw. Now let me tell you something. You cannot score and win from an environment which you have not taken responsibility. By virtue of the fact that you were Ugandan, what happens in this country concerns you. God was asking questions to Job. I wonder the born again of this generation. When I see them doing well, if you read Job 38, and you read 38 and 40, what you need to know that you can't do this.
And you go through. You be critical about God.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sometimes I question myself.
I'm
not sure what it can be.
For you
might woman of God and man, and to repent before God.